Welcome in, everyone. I am Andrew Posadas, and right now I am pleased to be joined by one of the 12 inductees into the 2021 Fordham Athletics Hall of Fame class. I am now joined by Ali Arat, who was part of Fordham Water Polo. He joined the Rams as a grad student for 2 years back in 2009 and 2010. He was named an All-American by the ACWPC in both of those years, becoming the first Fordham Water Polo All-American in over 25 years, also named CWPA All-Conference first team in those both years, led the team with 91 goals in 2010, and was the 2011 Vincent T. Lombardi winner. Ali, congratulations, and let's get right into it. What was your initial reaction to finding out that you would be in this 2021 Hall of Fame class?
I'm thrilled, obviously. I'm thrilled for myself, for my family, my coach, and my teammates. It's quite the honor, and I feel very privileged to be part of the Hall of Fame class.
Yeah, and again, as I mentioned, Ali, you came in as a grad student for 2 years. When you think about 2009 and coming into Fordham, did you even have any sort of inclinations, any expectations that your 2 years at Rose Hill would be as eventful and as successful as it ended up being?
No, I mean, it's quite an interesting story, because mine is somewhat not ordinary compared to most of my teammates. I was recruited by Coach Bill Harris as a grad student. And to be honest, I had no idea what to expect coming in. And I was coming for the education mostly, but I didn't want to quit playing water polo at the time. So I reached out to Coach Bill Harris along with a bunch of other coaches. And at that time, because of my graduate student status, he seemed to be the only one that took interest in me and recruited me to the program. So, I mean, this conversation, the reason why we're having it right now, it is because of Coach Harris and his incredible recruiting skills.
Yeah, and Ali, when we look at those 2 years and what you were able to do, I mentioned 91 goals. That was second in the nation that year. What are the fondest memories that you have in your 2 years there playing for Fordham Water Polo?
I mean, my fondest memory is obviously that I missed so much, and quite fond of is obviously the team environment and my teammates in the States. What I can say is, you know, goals and wins all aside, the environment that Coach Harris created and, you know, his cherry-picking skills when it comes to character and underwriting the players that he wanted to be in the program, that created an amazing team atmosphere. And that's frankly what I miss the most right now.
Yeah, and when you talk about that and those principles, that philosophy that you learned playing here at Fordham, what are some of those principles that you now take with you in real life and what you're doing currently?
No, I mean, Coach Harris is you know, his principles are usually set in stone. And he wouldn't let anybody cross those principles, irrespective of your role in the team. So, you know, for him, obviously, sports was important, but education came first. He really pushed us hard to pursue our classes, get good grades, and also have fun playing water polo. So a lot of takeaways that I got from him are still pillars of my business life even today.
And Ali, just for you, when you think back at your time on Rose Hill, what are some of the things you miss the most about living that campus life, you know, being a student athlete in college? What are some of your favorite memories that you think of?
Well, I wasn't based in Rose Hill. I mean, the graduate studies, it was in the city in our Manhattan campus. Mm-hmm. So I was actually commuting back and forth between the Bronx and Manhattan, and oftentimes twice a day because, you know, we'd have weight sessions in the mornings and practice in the afternoon. The commuting part, you know, I don't miss as much. But yeah. But yeah, I mean, being in Rose Hill, obviously an incredible campus, and we had a great facility there. Just really enjoyed being in that environment, which was very friendly. And athletes, not just water polo, but across all other sports, were respected tremendously. I think that's one thing, looking back on my time at Fordham, from coaches to staff, you know, even the teachers and the professors and everything, they tremendously respected the time you put into collegiate sports. And that was something that people saw a lot of value in. But people didn't respect the time commitment, I would say, as much as it was done in the States, and especially at Fordham Water Polo. So yeah, I mean, looking back, those are some of the, I guess, fond memories, I would say.
Yeah, and my final question for you, Ali, is now being inducted into the Fordham Athletics Hall of Fame, your place as one of the greatest Fordham water polo players is now set in stone, as you used that phrase earlier. When you think about that, in only just 2 years, being able to go down as one of the best water polo players to ever come to Fordham, what does that mean to you?
I think looking back, I was provided an opportunity by Coach Harris and by the Fordham water polo program. Obviously, the entire administrative staff, as well as my professors and the instructors, I was provided an opportunity, and I sort of took upon that opportunity, and I think I have delivered well athletically. I think one catch that that I should probably underline is, you know, water polo is a team sport, and without that coaching environment and without my teammates, it doesn't necessarily mean much, right? This accomplishment belongs to me as much as it belongs to them. So, you know, I'm incredibly honored today to be inducted to the Hall of Fame. And I would say it's not just me, but every single one of my teammates in that over that 2 years, and as well as the coaching staff, that deserves this recognition. I only think that I'm getting this on behalf of them.
Well said. He is one of the new inductees into the Fordham Athletics 2021 Hall of Fame class. He is one of the greatest Fordham water polo players that we have seen. He is Ali Arat. Ali, congratulations again on the induction.
Thank you. Thank you, Andrew. Much appreciated.
Thank you, Ali.